Thank you, sir, for giving me permission for talking in this bill. I am first welcoming this bill, I am very glad and ever like the Honorable Minister initiative about this thing to give you authentication of the institution so far the degrees, diplomas are concerned. The Footwear Design and Development Institution Bill 2017. Footwear and other leather and allied materials makes bags, wallets, briefcases, accessories, even used in automobile interiors and furnitures and decorations are widely used in modern life. It is widely traded commodity globally. The first keyword in the bill is design. The design, material and make tells about status, style, position and profession of a person and the establishment. So how important it is, so important it is. Proper fitting, as already narrated by my colleague, design and sole material and made to fit is essential to keep the gait, figure and orthopedic requirement also, and so on. Cinderella was identified by shoe, so it is identity also. People's identity can be in the various purpose. In the saddest story, in the history of Bengal, in India, and in India, Nawab Sirajuddaula, while eating from the in a boat from Bhagwan Gola, and he was in disguise. But as because he couldn't spare with her shoes, and by which he was caught and then identified by the spy boatman and caught, and that is the end, and the British enters our country. Footwear. Presently, trend of leather interior furniture and fashion dresses are which are the articles which have been vogue recently. The scope of the footwear and leather designing is becoming popular all over the world. On the health sector, besides designing for orthopedic uses in different shapes, shoes prevent some contaminated disease, very simple disease but khatarnak. Thus the hookworm and other worm infestation goes via foot, and because of open defecation, and goes by a foot to soul to blood. In pre-toilet era, in NRHM program in Tamil Nadu and West Bengal and many other states supplied Hawaii chappals to villagers and BPL category public to prevent that. This simple solution of safeguarding the foot from soils and the dirt is also narrated long back in a satire poem of Rabindranath Tagore called Juta Abhishkar, Discovery of Shoe. The second key point is that development, that this means research and innovation of newer models, research in invention of newer alternatives, as it is probably very much necessary in the present context of our political and government situations. Newer alternatives and similar material. Indian leather and allied industries have scope of growth in terms of local consumption as well as global export. In global perspective, China is the number one, Italy is the second, and India is in fifth position. The matter of raw material, local consumption and export, China, in the matter of raw material, local consumption as well as export, in China, everything is good. That is why China is in first position. India also have enormous scope of improving the leather industry because we can get the materials But unfortunately, due to some reasons or other, the simple Sampradaya 9 may be stopped in near future. The India is shifting from mere raw material to value-added exporter also. Local consumption is also increasing. So being every scope of this flourishing of this leather industry, which is a very much valuable for Indian economy, I don't think how much we can do with this present situation. India shares about 12.2% of global export, and in coming years it will be much more if we try and we don't give some barriers in the raw material. Major share of the export goes to our export goes to US, UK, then Germany and these things. Export footwear contributes about 47%, accessories is about 23%, and finished products 18%, and garments also in 9%. But at this moment, footwear is little less in export. Per capita footwear use have also increased. In India, Kolkata holds the second position for production as well as export. 25% of tanning is done in Kolkata. 50% of finished leather goods of India are exported from Kolkata only. Footwear and leather industry plays a vital role in Indian economy. Besides export, this industry being most labor dependent or labor consuming, I would say, it has huge scope of youth employment, especially when they will be skilled labor under supervision of qualified administrators. In leather work, there is quite a good number of women folk who are, as already told by Ranjita, that they are mostly in the unorganized sector. They do the basic work of shoes at home, maybe women, non-women. Previously in Calcutta, there was many Chinese karigars who used to be good, but now they have all shifted. They help in finished product preparation. So this is the industry which have immense scope of women empowerment. But I don't know how much the establishment of this institution can do that. I'll come to that later on. This is why the present institution is in question of national importance. Yes, this could be, but with some policy changes. This bill is very pertinent to this context. It deals with the institution for education, research and innovation of modern techniques as regards footwear and other leather products. The clause 1 is regarding title of the bill. I wonder why it is only footwear. There are bigger parties, other portions also. So whether instead of footwear only, the other things like leather and allied articles can be incorporated in the bill. The bill is regarding establishment of an educational institute to affiliate the footwear and leather industry to a national and international. We are hoping more and more. The directive body, as it is said, is governing council with chairman, managing director, and whom are all footwear and leather technology expertise. And I am also quite with Ranjita that why should industrialists be there? Because that will create a problem by putting it in other way around, directing it in other way. In spite of youth employment, it will go to some other way. Somebody's pocket will be big. The bill deals with formatting, running, remuneration, tenure. Madam, 1 minute more, please. There is nobody else in my, please. Study and working courses will be determined and decided by the council. The courses are about designing, making, research, these sort of things. But these leather institutions, as LDC, was already in existence, but they have no power to confer degree. Now we are trying through this bill to give some degrees. Now my question is, what the hell it will do, giving a diploma degrees to these fellows? Where will they be employed exactly? It is not clear in my mind. Maybe minister will guide me. And what, as we are worried about is that actually what is needed is the center should be more under the skill development center, so that the smaller productions and the smaller tanning institutions will be employed by the skilled person, so that we can grow more, we can establish relation of the and there is not clear relation of the branches. There are several branches. What is the relation between the intern branch? What is the how you will recruit the students, and what will be the how you recruit the teachers, and also what is the qualification of the teacher? These are not clear in this the bill. How could the tuition will be able to, tuition fee will be able to clear? Center will give. Sir, 1 minute. Madam, you always ring bell with me.
What about promotion? It is 3:30. Is the time of the private
members. Workers through institution. We want to establish the small factories or big factories. And you know already in Calcutta, Kolhapur or whatever it is, there were factories. Bata Shoe Company is famous all over, and the Khadim and all. So how this can be utilized or be manpower will be given to them through this.
Okay, thank you.
This bill. That is my question. Thank you very much.
Item number 20.